Welcome to another edition of How to Fix It Yourself with Dave and Dave. Today we're doing the third installment on the sunroof on the Pathfinder 2001. So you saw the episode where we showed how to replace the motor and be able, you know, because the other one had burned out and wasn't working properly. We then had a few items that didn't go quite right. So you saw the next video where we repaired some of the interior parts that needed to get fixed in order to make the interior look proper. Now, this is kind of the last of that group. This particular one, we're going to talk about cleaning the runners on the sunroof. Now, sometime back, we did one on how to clean the runners on the windows, the back window, the passenger windows, the driver's windows, the back seat windows. For that one, we talked about using a spray silicone lubricant. And we talked about using just a little bit and not going too much. Now, as you saw in a previous video, if you have real silicone weather strip problems, this may not be quite enough. But if you've been keeping on top of it, this will work fine. However, it will not be a good choice to use on the sunroof, because it's a spray, it's likely to get all over everything. You really want to keep away from doing any kind of a spraying on your sunroof, because it's easy for it to drop right down in the car, get on the seats, dashboard, anywhere else that you don't want things. So do not use something like this on your sunroof. So the critical items are the rubber gasket here, which again is a silicone rubber gasket. We'll talk about how to rejuvenate that. And then all the slide mechanisms down in here. So one of the first things you need to do is clean things up. Make sure you get rid of most of the old grease and most of the old dirt. Make sure things are clean. One of the items that we're not going to show you, but to be aware of, is there are four drain tubes on each sunroof. So the drain tubes are in the four corners of the sunroof, and they're there to allow moisture and water that does get past the rubber seal to have some place to go rather than to accumulate and drip into your car. If you have moisture coming into your car from your sunroof, it may not actually be the rubber seals. It may be that your drain tubes are clogged. That's a whole separate issue, a whole separate video. There's some videos out there that talk about it. Not completely happy with any of them, but we're not going to do that in this particular one. So just be aware that that might be an additional issue. So the first thing we want to do is to clean out all the running surfaces and all the slide surfaces that are in here. Yours will probably look a little different than the Pathfinder's, but you'll notice that I have cleaned it all out, so it's all basically clean. I've already got a layer of silicone grease on there. This particular version that I used was the Honda version that we talked about earlier. So I used the Honda Sinetchu grease. It's very good quality, has good stain power, a good one to use. Again, as mentioned in our previous video about sealing surfaces, you might also want to use, just a standard grease paste. But whichever one you use, you want to make sure that you use it real lightly and don't go too much. Now, one of the reasons why you see a little bit extra on these parts right here is because it's very difficult to get back under the sunroof to be able to grease those surfaces. So initially you want to make it a little heavier and then operate the mechanism several times to distribute the grease and make sure the grease moves around. So that's why it's important to get rid of the old grease. So at this point where we've operated it several times, you just need to take something like a paper towel and just go ahead and just give it a nice easy wipe down. Don't do it too hard because you want to still have the residual on there. But you don't want to have so much that it's going to be a grease trap, or a dirt trap, excuse me, not a grease trap, a dirt trap. So you want to just kind of wipe them down, make sure that there's still a residual on there because it really doesn't take very much. And that'll kind of be your final clean that you'll do on your surfaces after you get that grease on there. Be sure you get all the pivot points, get all those lubed and make sure that they're all working nice and smoothly. If you have a lift groove for lifting the your sunroof, then make sure you get grease inside of that for the pin that is going inside there. All right, so we've now cleaned it, we've now lubed it. Now, the other critical part that we need to talk about is the rubber seal. If you've watched our video on the weather seals in the doors, very similar, except this time I only recommend using a good quality silicone grease. Again, I like the Honda one. The paste works just as well, but this time you're going to put the grease on the surfaces. Be sure you get the top, the front, the bottom, and you need to let it sit. So you're going to have to leave your sunroof open for 24, 48 hours to let it soak in. Then you want to come back by and do just a wipe, just to get the excess off of there so you're not attracting dirt. Now, we don't have a real before picture unless you look at how we replaced the motor, but this was actually quite white. It had some real sun damage to it. So you'll notice when I run my finger down, it doesn't leave a residue. You'll notice the seal surfaces are all nice and soft, so they're going to provide a very good seal. So you really need to use the silicone grease on these surfaces here in order to keep it rejuvenated. Again, this would be great to do twice a year. Make sure your seals are all very good. Don't forget to clean and put a light lube along the edge of your metal framing, because that's where the rubber seals seal. And you want to make sure those are clean and you're not having a lot of dirt or twigs or anything build up in there that's going to interrupt the sealing so that water can get past those. So that's kind of a wrap up of our series on taking care of the sunroof on the Pathfinder. Hope you found the whole sequence useful, especially the part where if you have trouble, there's always ways of fixing things. You just have to be creative. In this case, it doesn't take a whole lot of creativity. It just takes a little time and energy and effort to make sure that you get all the surfaces clean, taken care of, get the rubber seal rejuvenated, and you'll be good to go and be able to have a good operating moonroof or sunroof for many a year. Again, click on the subscribe button if you haven't already clicked. Click on the bell to be notified when a new episode is available. And be sure and use the links below to purchase any of the products that we've talked about today.